Welcome to worship here at Trinity. As we begin, raise your hand if you did not get a name tag. If you did not get a name tag, our very helpful usher Silas is bringing forward some name tags to people who have their hands up, because today we are welcoming new members. So as we begin in this time of welcome, a special welcome to those who worship with us online and channel 987. We're glad you're tuning in. And many of us are gathered here in person. People are getting their name tags, and I'm Pastor Madeline. I serve as associate pastor here at Trinity, up here alongside Pastor Amy, our lead pastor. Sue Bradley is our assisting minister tonight. Maggie's on the piano. We have TJ on the saxophone. John and Diane Lonsdale as ushers, Bristol as our acolyte. Such a wealth of volunteering and talent that makes services like this possible. Some special things happening tonight in worship. We get to welcome more new members. That's the third time this year. We have 7 different households and 15 people who want to join this living community of Christ because they feel at home here. That's what they said in new member orientation. So keep it up, church. Be sure to connect with new members at Pi Fest. And tonight we also have 3 young people who will receive First Communion. Will those 3 people please stand so we can see who you are? And we're so excited. Go ahead and have a seat. We will call you up again later in the service. We have so much to be thankful for. This is why we gather to worship God, who in eternal love has given us salvation through Jesus Christ our Lord. This free gift of grace makes us strong and emboldens us to share our blessings with others, speak up for the oppressed, and stand for justice in a warring world. Because of God's grace, we rejoice. We have hope. We give thanks. Please stand as you are able, and let us give thanks to God for the gift of baptism.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker and ruler of all things. Your voice thundered over the waters at creation.
You water the mountains and send springs into the valleys to refresh and satisfy all living things.
Through the waters of the flood, you carried those in the ark to safety. Through the sea, you led your people Israel from slavery into freedom. In the wilderness, you nourished them with water from the rock, and you brought them across the River Jordan to the promised land.
By the baptism of his death and resurrection, your son Jesus has carried us to safety and freedom.
The flood shall not overwhelm us, and the deep shall not swallow us up, for Christ has brought us over to the land of promise. Jesus sends us to make disciples, baptizing in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Pour out your Holy Spirit, O God. Wash away our sin in this cleansing water. Clothe us with Christ and claim your children, no longer slave or free, no longer male or female, but one with all the baptized in Christ Jesus, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen. In peace, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray to the Lord. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, gracious Lord. Amen. This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia. Sing.
As part of our prayers this evening, happy birthday, TJ, we are going to include the welcome of our new members. So if you are a new member, please come forward at this time. This is an exciting day. The Holy Spirit is ever working among us, and this is proof. We are blessed to have all these people desiring to join this congregation today, and I wrote in parentheses, clap. So I think that's for you. Clap. Yeah. Good job. Good job. Good job, everybody. Yay, yay, yay. Okay. 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 We have here, at Trinity, we believe God has called us together to be a living community of Christ in this time and place. Hey, guys. We are working and growing in community with God, each other, and the world, and we are deeply blessed to have these new folks join us in this community. So, Terry Wenzel is here, who is a longtime member, and he's reaffirming his membership here. Michelle Vasquez and her daughters, Ellie, Angel, Faith, thank you. Okay, the Vasquez family, David and Sally Waddle, Ben Burns, John and Darla Yazumbek. I mean, I'm a Welshly. I have to try it, right? You've seen how my last name is spelled. Katie Panagas, Katie and Nicholas Panagas and... Okay. Are you getting married? Are you going to lose that name when you get married? Which is? Tahoka. There's an L in that, you guys. Yeah. Yes. And we have Leanne and Dusty Jacobson and their children, Stu and Tess. And we are... Okay. I mean, he's not up here, but his parents are still going to bring him. Don't spoil it for him, though. It'll be fine. It's always fine. We love you, Stu. Okay. I'm glad you're here. In baptism, we are welcomed into the body of Christ and sent to share in the mission of God. We are called to live among God's faithful people in community, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth. To those who are joining this community, do you intend to continue in the covenant of your baptism among God's people in this place? If so, please answer.
I do.
Congregation, please stand as you are able. And new members, please turn to face the congregation. People of God, do you promise to support and pray for these new members in their life in Christ? If so, please answer. We do, and we ask God to help and guide us.
We do, and we ask God to help and guide us. We are going to pray together, so new members turn back around so you can see what we're going to pray. All right, let us pray. Almighty God, by the love of Jesus Christ and the power of the Holy Spirit, you have called us together to be your people. Thank you for blessing each of this members. Embracing them. Guide us as we continue to welcome all people just as you welcome them. Keep us close together in your spirit, in the breaking of bread and the prayers, and in service to others, following the example of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us welcome these friends into this living community of Christ. love that. Thank you, choir. I'd like to invite all our kids forward, please, at this time, even those who are taller than me, even those who are in high school. Oh, weird. We'll have to look at that. Hey, Parker. Oh, there's more than one Parker here. What is happening? Sarayla, you are dressed perfectly for tonight. And you are too! Okay, Ronan is wearing his elf PJs, and Sarayla has reindeer antlers on. And do you know what is happening on Sunday? It's the first Sunday of Advent already. Did you know that? Oh, yeah, you read the sign? Oh. Okay, well, you know now. So here's something that we are going to do. I wonder, we have a little display case down the hall. Should we go look at that first? Okay. Follow Pastor Madeline, because my microphone, you got to hustle. My microphone will not reach all the way down there. Eric and I tested it today. Okay, follow Pastor Madeline, and then come right back. So in our cleaning up of all of our historical things, we have stored some of the items that have lived in that glass case for time immemorial. And we are going to use the glass case in that hallway when you're first coming in for different display items. And we are going to invite you to participate in that. So, and don't worry, nothing was thrown away. Everything is still here. But we decided, let's make it interactive and display some things. Also, this is relevant, I mean, as long as I have time. Sunday we're doing Hanging of the Greens. Have you ever helped with Hanging of the Greens before? Brian Godfrey, Lori Godfrey? And we have, it's fast, it's fun, it's festive. I'm sure this is not like the Pied Piper. They will come back, right? Oh, I hear them. Okay. Oh my gosh. Here they come. Round the corner. We got two winners of the race. Oh, good. Okay. Yay! Did you see what we were talking about, that glass case? Did you see it, Sarayla? Okay. Come and kneel down, peeps. So, for the first item that I want to invite you and or the congregation to share with us. Now note, this is not giving something to the church, okay? Because then I have to decide what to do with it. Please. But if you have a manger scene, do you guys have a manger scene at home? Yes? I have a manger. If you have an extra manger scene at home that you want to display, something that's meaningful to you, this is one that belongs to my children. And look, my name is on the bottom, Pastor Amy, so that it can come back to me. And I have all these awesome pieces that go with it. The veggie tail lambs. Oh, a cow costume. Oh, look, this is Pigpen. He's a wise man. I don't know why Linus doesn't look like anything. You know, I think, oh, look, Snoopy's a lamb. You can put a great white shark in there. I don't see why not, Stuart. I don't see why not. So if you have, do you guys have a manger scene at home?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. Do all you guys have a manger scene at home? Yeah? Well, but there are some folks that I didn't ask, Ronan. If you have one that is meaningful to you, it will be kept secure. And if you would like it displayed here at church so that other people can experience it, I would like you to bring it to church, okay? Bring it to church on Sunday, and we will make sure that we have some information like your name and where you got it or what's meaningful about it. Okay? Okay. Thank you for going on a field trip with Pastor Madeline. You may go back to your seats. Okay, Stuart, help me put them back in, would you? Oh, you can? Sorry, no. Okay. Okay. All right. Thanks, everybody.
The lesson this evening is from Deuteronomy, the 8th chapter, starting at the 7th verse. For the Lord your God is bringing you into a good land, a land with flowing streams, with springs and underground waters welling up in valleys and hills, a land of wheat and barley, of vines and fig trees and pomegranates, a land of olive trees and honey, a land where you may eat bread without scarcity, where you will lack nothing, a land whose stones are iron and from whose hills you may mine copper. You shall eat your fill and bless the Lord your God for the good land that he has given you. Take care that you do not forget the Lord your God by failing to keep his commandments, his ordinances, and his statutes, which I am commanding you today. When you have eaten your fill and have built fine houses and live in them, and when your herds and flocks have multiplied, and your silver and your gold is multiplied, and all that you have is multiplied, then do not exalt yourself, forgetting the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, who led you through the great and terrible wilderness, an arid wasteland with poisonous snakes and scorpions. He made water flow for you from flint rock and fed you in the wilderness with manna that your ancestors did not know, to humble you and to test you, and in the end to do you good. Do not say to yourself, my power and the might of my own hand have gotten me this wealth. But remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to get wealth, so that he may confirm his covenant that he swore to your ancestors, as he is doing today. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please responsively the psalm. You are to be praised, O God, in Zion. To you shall vows be fulfilled. To you, the one who answers prayer, to you all flesh shall come. Our sins are stronger than we are, but you blot out our transgressions. Happy are those who choose and draw to your courts to dwell there. They will be satisfied by the beauty of your house, by the holiness of your temple. Awesome things will you show us in your righteousness, O God of our salvation. O hope of all the ends of the earth and of the oceans far away. You make firm the mountains by your power. You are girded about with might. You still the roaring of the seas, the roaring of their waves, and the clamor of the peoples. Those who dwell at the ends of the earth will tremble at your marvelous signs. You make the dawn and the dusk to sing for joy. You visit the earth and water it abundantly. You make it very plenteous. The river of God is full of water. You prepare the grain, so you provide for the earth. You drench the furrows and smooth out the ridges. With heavy rain, you soften the ground and bless its increase. You drench the furrows and smooth out the ridges. With heavy rain, you soften the ground and bless its increase. You crown the year with your goodness, and your plants overflow. May the fields of the wilderness be rich for grazing, and the hills be clothed with joy. May the meadows cover themselves with flocks, and the valleys cloak themselves with grain. Let them shout for joy and sing.
Our lesson comes to us from the book of Luke, chapter 17. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was going through the region between Samaria and Galilee. As he entered a village, 10 lepers approached him. Keeping their distance, they called out to him, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourselves to the priests." And as they went, they were made clean. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice. He prostrated himself at Jesus' feet and thanked him. And he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus asked, "Were not 10 made clean? But the other 9, where are they? Was none of them found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" Then he said to him, "Get up and go on your way. Your faith has made you well." Praise the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. So have you ever written a thank you note? I surely have. I've written a great many in my day. I may have written some to you over the years here. I was taught by my parents how to write a thank you note. It is supposed to be prompt, so shortly after the event or the gift was given. It should be sincere, and if you are going to put a stamp on that envelope, you better write a whole letter, because a stamp is money, so make it count, right? Absolutely. I distinctly remember writing 5 thank you notes when I was in high school to my friends Joey, Nikki, Amy, Danny, and Joseph. And it was on the occasion of their graduation when I was still a sophomore in high school. And yes, you heard me right. I did not send them congratulations or best wishes cards. I wrote thank you notes. You see, my heart had some things to say. While my 5 friends and I, we had promised to stay close forever, I knew that it was going to be different. I had 2 older sisters who had already gone off to college, and while they treasured their friendships from high school, it was hard to navigate. Things were different. It just wasn't the same. So I sat down and I wrote my gratitude and love, and I sealed those cards and I did not use a stamp. I went to their grad parties and I put those cards in the card baskets. And you know what? It was different after they graduated. But I was not sad, because I had said what I really felt. I marked the occasion, remembered what mattered, and our lives carried on. The people Jesus healed in today's gospel lesson, they got carried away rejoicing. There is a difference between being carrying on and carried away. The best I can explain it is this: carried on is to remember, but carried away is to forget. When we get carried away with our lives, we tend to forget the people or events or values that matter. But when we carry on with our lives, we do so remembering what matters. The people, events, and values go with us always. So, 9 of the people that Jesus healed were carried away with rejoicing. But one man marked the moment with gratitude. One man turned back to thank Jesus for the miracle, the mercy, the meeting. One man who was already the odd man out, since he was a different denomination of Judaism, right? He was a Samaritan. One man carried on. And yes, he'll do exactly what Jesus commands. He will present himself to the priest to be an evidence of healing. And yes, he too is full of rejoicing. He praises Jesus. But first, this one man gives thanks to Jesus. And you know what? I want to be like this one man. I want to be oriented to thanksgiving and gratitude and telling the story of what God has done. I want to be like this man and make my praise of God a priority. Because you know what? I have been healed too. Jesus found me in the in-between places of my life. Just one encounter with Christ, and I am made new. And so are you. Jesus, our Savior, is still the same today as he was in this story. Jesus still goes into the gray areas like the region between Samaria and Galilee. Jesus still heals the most unexpected people and brings hope to those that we have written off as hopeless. Jesus still commands us to tell the story to the people who claim to know it best. Our Savior is still the same, loving all people, working for those in need, giving his very life for the sake of the world. Church, I want to carry on and resist getting carried away. I never want to forget what God has done for me, because his love has shaped my whole life. I am sustained in my weakness. I am comforted when I am weary. I am confident when I am the odd one out, because I know that God loves me. God loves you. God loves us. Let our praise and thanksgiving be prompt and sincere, and let us make it count.
Please rise as you are able.
Thank you.
Let us confess our faith together using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us turn our hearts to God, our breath and life, as we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. When we pray over the names of people in need of healing, you're welcome to add the names of those who are on your heart. Let us pray. Generous God, we thank you for the legacy and gift of the church. Make our proclamation clear, our generosity bold, and our community rich in welcome. We raise grateful hearts for this living community of Christ where we find belonging. Hear us, O God. Creator of the earth, the bounty of creation reveals your abundant love. Save us from the waste of natural resources. We raise grateful hearts for the earth, our home. Hear us, O God. God of all nations, make each nation a place where peace and justice is realized and celebrated. We pray especially for Palestine, Israel, and Ukraine. Protect any who are vulnerable and feed all who are hunger. We raise grateful hearts for leaders who are just. Hear us, O God. Healing God, you see us and are moved with compassion. Attend to those who are sick or dying. Surround with love all who need comfort and healing. We pray especially for Eric, Clarence, Olaf, Rick, Pat, Jen, Drew, Jim, Izzy, Mike, and those we name before you now. We raise grateful hearts for your loving kindness. Hear us, O God. Excuse me. God of welcome and love, you gather people to be shaped by your word. Bless us, your church, as we strive to follow your example of serving our neighbors. We raise grateful hearts for the gift of being your people. Hear us, O God. God of life, you raise those who have died to live in Christ, new life in Christ. We raise grateful hearts for the lives and faithfulness of all the saints. Hear us, O God. We offer our spoken prayers and those held in our hearts, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Please share a sign of peace with one another. Thank you. Let us pray. O Lord, maker of all things, we praise you for crowning the fields with your blessings and enabling us to gather in the fruits of the earth to share with all people. Teach us to use your gifts carefully, that our land may continue to yield its increase through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
As we prepare for the sacrament of Holy Communion, we thank God for each of you and welcome you to the Lord's table. There is a place for you here. No matter how often you go to church or whether you have doubts, Jesus has already invited everyone to this meal. We pray you experience the presence of the Holy Spirit and that you will always know how much God loves you. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God our thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who invites us to a meal that unites us in every age, brought to your font of everlasting life and forgiveness. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And so we continue to celebrate this meal and pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. At this time, I will invite forward the young people who are receiving First Communion, along with their families, to gather at the railing and kneel as you are able. Today is a day of gratitude and togetherness. We pray to you, O God, in the name of the one who endured the cross, forgives our sin, and feeds us at his table, Jesus Christ our Lord. In this sacrament, sustain all people and surround them with supportive community. Today we specially name Carly, Noah, and Parker. Fill them with your love and surround them with supportive community, one in the body of Christ, from the furthest reaches of our relationships to the core of our very self. Together, we make the love of Jesus known and felt. Taste and see that God is good. Come to the banquet, for all is now ready.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, in this simple meal, you have set a banquet. Sustain us on the journey, strengthen us to care for the least of your beloved children, and give us glad and generous hearts as we meet you on the way. Amen.
Okay, friends, Christmas neighbor trees tags are out and ready, and they are downstairs. So if you would like to give a gift for Christmas neighbors, we have upped the number of families that we're helping this year because we always get asked to take more. So we're starting with 15 instead of 10. So check out the tree downstairs. Sunday is the last day for donations for winter warmth. You know what that is? It is a STAR project that helps the schools help children who need boots or snow pants. And if you aren't going to be shopping between now and Sunday, but you want to help, there are envelopes in the back labeled Winter Warmth, and you could put $5 in there. And as Kay Falk said earlier this season, the Star Group would have a ball shopping for you. So we'll just a couple dollars from everybody really helps. First week of Advent, hanging of the greens, the pledge forms and volunteer forms, please turn those in. You have had an excellent turnout. Thank you so much for the pledge forms. It really does help us budget well. And last call for poinsettias, okay? It's a good deal. All right, the Pies Fest starts now, so we need to sing our table prayer. It's to the doxology.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all natures here below. Praise Father, Son, heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Be present at our table.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and grant you peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, amen. Go in peace and eat some pie. Thanks be to God. You are dismissed. Yeah.